Hello, my beautiful friends. It's Amanda here, and today I'm going to share with you some recommendations for the Sephora VIB sale. Typically, at the end of the month, I like to post a monthly favorites, but we're switching it up a little bit because this big sale is dropping at Sephora soon. I wanted to give you my top 10 favorite, most recommended products from Sephora. That way, it's still kind of a favorites, but it's not an October favorites. This is a Sephora favorites, and hopefully that helps you to make some good decisions when you are spending that hard-earned cash at Sephora. So first things first, the holiday savings event is kicking off for Rouge members. They get 20% off from October 30th through November 9th. Then the Sephora VIB members get 15% off from November 3rd through November 9th. And the insiders get 10% off between November 5th and November 9th. So I'm gonna try my best to post this video right at the beginning of the sale for the Rouge members. And I'm not really recommending a bunch of new hotness. These are more things that are my tried and true, things that I've been using for a long time, things that I've repurchased, and products that I just really, really enjoy. I also tried to choose things that I think are gonna work for a lot of people. So that's why I'm not really including any skincare, fragrances, things like that. I tried to choose things that I think are really gonna be overall good recommendations for a lot of different people. So let's start with lips. I'm not ranking these. I'm not doing them in any particular order. I'm just gonna do them in categories because I think that's easier for my brain to comprehend. So I'm gonna recommend two different lip products. These are both lip products that I have loved, used up, repurchased, highly recommended for a really long time. First is from Laneige. This is the Lip Glowy Balm. The one that I'm showing right now is called Gummy Bear. This is one of their newer scents, but I've loved every different version of the Lip Glowy Balm. I think I have used up and repurchased the berry flavor the most, but I love them all. I highly, highly recommend these. I will no doubt be picking up a couple of backups because I have used at least half a dozen of these, and I think if you're gonna really spend a good chunk of change on a lip product, personally, I prefer to do so on something that I know I'm gonna completely use up, which you'll see because my other recommendation is also a lip balm. I'm sure that for some people it feels like the opposite. You know, you can go and buy a lip balm at the drugstore for $2.99 or whatever, but this is the kind of product that I'm going to continually use and love and carry around in my pocket, carry around in my bag. And I like having that feeling of luxury all the time, especially when it comes to my lip products. So that's why my other lip recommendation comes from NARS. The one that I have here is the shade Laguna. I would say my top favorite is Torrid or maybe Dolce Vita. I can't find my Torrid Afterglow lip balm. I'm pretty sure it's in the bottom of my tote bag upstairs. And that's how you know it's my favorite, because it's floating around in a bag somewhere. But really, it just depends on which flavors and which colors you prefer. Overall, formula-wise, value-wise, I highly recommend both of these balms. Now let's move on to the face. I have one complexion product that I want to recommend. Like I said, I want to try to keep these recommendations as broad and universal as possible, but I think that almost any skin type could enjoy this product. I feel like I've been raving about this for 2 years. This is the Too Faced Born This Way Super Coverage Concealer. As you can see, mine is well used, well loved. This is at least my second one of these. I cannot tell you how much I love this concealer. I wear it all over as a foundation. You can wear just a little bit as a concealer. It has tons of great coverage. It's not too matte for my dry skin. I don't think that it would be too dewy for oilier skin. It's just that perfect in between, really natural, satiny skin finish. I can't say enough good things about this concealer. I do think this is one of the best concealers on the market. And if you're looking for some great coverage, this is it. This is what you're looking for, 100%. Okay, let's talk about some cheek colors. I want to start with a highlighter that I absolutely love. And this is a brand that really does not get a lot of airtime on this channel. This is from Benefit. This is their highlighter in the shade Cookie. I typically don't really go crazy for these little box products from Benefit. Usually they're neither here nor there for me. And honestly, this highlighter is so incredible. I'm gonna swatch it for you so you can see just how soft and beautiful it is. I barely touched into the pan and just look at it on my finger. Oh my gosh. So let's do a little swatch moment here. It somehow manages to be super bright, super shiny, but it also just melts into the skin. You can definitely wear it really concentrated like this if you want a mega, mega bright highlight, or you can wear it kind of blended out on the skin and it just gives this gorgeous shine. I'm not somebody that has really gone crazy for a lot of Benefit products. They just don't really do that much for me. They don't do much to excite me. And this excites me. This is a stunning highlighter. Why can't all of Benefit's products be this good? This is a really, really darn good highlighter. I think this would be a great thing to pick up during the sale because I do think the price tag's a little bit high for this one, but if you can snag it on sale, it's definitely worth it. It's pretty. It's really nice. It's really, really nice. I have two more cheek products I want to recommend. One is a cream blush and one is a blush and highlighter duo. These are both sort of newer to my collection. I did get both of these this year, but they've both been in favorites videos. They've both been well loved. We'll start with this little cream blush. This is the Cheeks Out Freestyle Cream Blush from Fenty Beauty by Rihanna. This is my favorite shade. It's the one called Rosé Latte. That's Rosé Latte. This formula is so beautiful, so blendable. You can increase the intensity based on just how dramatic you want your blush to be or how light or deep your skin tone is. I was afraid that this color was going to be a little bit too dark for me because I do have a pretty light skin tone, but just the tiniest bit of this blended out gives me such a beautiful, natural looking flush. I also have the shades Petal Poppin' and Cool Berry. I like both of those too, but there's just something about this really gorgeous rosy terracotta color that I've really gravitated towards, and I think this would look so beautiful on so many different skin tones. I have a whole video about these blushes. Any review videos that I've done with the products I'm recommending, I will link down in the description if you want more information. But I gave these a rave review and I've loved them ever since. The last cheek product I want to recommend is from Kosas. This is their duo in the shade Contra Chroma. This is a powder duo. They also have a cream duo that's definitely on my list to try. I've just been enjoying this little powder duo so much. Maybe that's something I'll purchase from the sale for myself. Now, I know this does not look like much in the pan. I had the same thought when I first tried this. I actually have a first impressions of this where I tried it for the first time on camera and I was blown away because this looks very muted in the pan. It looks very matte, very one note. And I have to tell you, this on the cheeks is so beautiful, so unexpected, at least for me. I think even in the swatch, it doesn't really look that crazy impressive. But This looks so, so beautiful on the cheeks. They have several different colors, and one of the things that I like about this product from Kosas, they have a high intensity version of each one of these duos. So there is, for example, this one's Contra Chroma. There is a Contra Chroma high intensity, which is a little bit deeper and a little bit brighter. So it's meant to cater to a deeper skin tone. I think that's such a good idea. And this is such a beautiful formula. This has been a surprise smash hit for me, and I think that it would be for you too. So that's why I'm recommending this. I also think that their blush duos are better than their bronzer, and the hype for their little glowy baked bronzer was crazy, but I think this is the better product, just for me, in my opinion, personally. All right, the last category is for eyes. I have two palettes, a mascara, and a single eyeshadow that I want to recommend. Let's start with the single eyeshadow. This is a product from Tarte. This is their Chrome Paint Shadow Pot. Much like the Cookie Highlighter from Benefit, I think this is probably most exciting and most high quality product that Tarte has released in a while. I kind of haven't had my eye on them in a little bit. I'm gonna show you a swatch of this. This is such a cool product. So this is a loose pigment, but it has a moisture to it, not a super dry, powdery type of pigment. It's really, really cool. You'll see when I swatch it here just how beautiful and bright and shiny it is. Do you see that? How could you not want that all over your eyelids, honestly? I have four shades in this little Tarte Chrome Paint Shadow Pot. This one is my favorite. It's called Wild at Heart. It's got this gorgeous shift. It's sort of a warm baby pink that shifts to this really bright bluish green. I think it's so pretty. It's so cool. I'm happy to see Tarte doing something that feels innovative and feels a little bit different. This is another product that I think is best to purchase on sale because these individual shadows are pretty expensive. It's not the kind of thing that most people are going to quickly completely use up. So I think this is a great product. Really like it, really enjoy it, but I do think this is something that's best left to purchase during a sale. If you've been watching my videos lately, this will probably be no surprise. I've been wearing this mascara for the last couple of months. Basically, since it launched, I have been using nothing but the Huda Beauty Legit Lashes Mascara. I totally thought this was going to be a gimmick. It does have two sides. So it has a curl and length side, and then it has a volume side. I thought it was going to be gimmicky. I did not think it was going to be worth the price tag. I didn't think it was going to be that great. And man, I was wrong. I really, really like the way that this mascara makes my lashes look. I like that I can customize how dramatic they are. If I just want just a little something, kind of a light makeup day, more natural look, then I just use the curl and length side, and it defines my lashes a little bit. It makes them look a little bit longer, a little bit wispier, but it still looks like a really, really natural lash. And then, for example, when I'm wearing a little bit more eye makeup or I want to do just a more intense lash, add a little bit of drama to my look, then I will use the curl and length side, let that dry for a minute, and then go back over with the volume side to turn up the volume just a little bit on those lashes. It's not a gimmick. Or if it is, it's, at least it works. I don't know what to say, but I'm very surprised at how much I love this mascara, and I'm probably gonna pick up one during the sale because this is my second tube and it's about time for me to get another one. Okay, we are in the home stretch here. I have two products left to recommend. They are both palettes, and if you've watched my channel for any length of time, then neither one of these are gonna be a surprise to you because they are two palettes that I have loved and raved about time and time again. Another product from Huda Beauty. This is the Mercury Retrograde palette. This was my number one palette of 2019. It's been over a year since this came out, and I still think this is one of the best most interesting palettes in my collection. The fact that this has remained on top for over a year, despite all of the dozens, if not hundreds, of other palettes that I've tried in the meantime, I think that really says something about this. I think this color story is still relevant. It's still interesting. Seeing as I've raved about this palette for over a year, I will not go on, but I have to say, 10 out of 10, still recommend. This is a pricier palette, so it'd be great to be able to grab it during a sale, but it's good. It's really good. It's really good, guys. The last product that I want to recommend is a palette that I have really loved. This is definitely a contender for my best of 2020 palettes. This baby is from Melt Cosmetics. This is the Rust palette. This is the way to do a neutral palette that's really interesting, that's really useful, user-friendly. It's beautiful. I highly recommend this palette. The formula is beautiful. This is another one that I have really talked a lot about. I did do a full review on this. I gave it, of course, a glowing review, and this is another one that's pretty pricey. I do think this is worth the price tag, but I mean, it never hurts to get things on sale, at least in my opinion. Those are my top 10 products at Sephora that I would recommend to anyone and everyone who will bother to listen. I've used and loved these products for a long time and they have not failed me yet, so hopefully you will feel the same way if you take my recommendations. I would love to hear what your top products from Sephora are. Are you picking up anything during the holiday savings event? What's on your wish list? Do you want to see my wish list? It might be a little late for that. I don't know, we'll see. Let me know what your top picks are, if you want to hear about what's on my wish list, or if you just want to wait and be surprised for the haul if I get anything. I always love to know what you think about things too, so make sure you leave all your comments down below. As always, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye! Huh? And what was I saying? I don't know where I'm going with this. I got the hands, but I don't have any words coming out of my mouth. I think, or. Help. Was that shady? Sorry. But really though, I'll wait. I don't know. I have two blushes. Freestyle. Cheeks Out Freestyle Cream Blush. Why do we have to give every product the longest name ever? This thing is too tiny to have a name that long. Okay, I'm not coming for you, Rihanna. I respect you, but honestly. Have you guys seen the new big palette that she's about to come out with? I've only seen pictures of it. I haven't seen it in person. I'm gonna have to reserve my judgment until I see it in person, because I don't know. I genuinely don't know. It might be awesome. Promo pictures really do fool us sometimes. You know that. I know that. I don't know. Anyway, let's focus on the task at hand here. I love this palette. No, we know. It's in your favorites. Okay, cool. Cool. Or if you're just not, I don't know what I'm saying. Someone send help. What? Okay, I've been talking for so long that I am sick of listening to myself talk. But I have to finish up one more video that I have in the works. But anyway, I love your face. And I hope that you're having a good day. And if you're not, then come here, I'll give you a hug. Come on, bring it in. Okay, all right, okay. I love your face, bye.